The following is a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.
For this particular team that you see getting ready for tonight's lacrosse game, yes, indeed, lacrosse, professional lacrosse, is hitting Halifax for the first time tonight. For another team, well, it's a new beginning. Yes, it's the Halifax Thunderbirds against the New York Riptide next. It's the NLL on BR Live. And good evening, everyone. I'm Pete Dalladay, along with Scott Arnold here tonight at the Scotiabank Center. And yes, it's a huge night for lacrosse and the city of Halifax, Scott. Huge night for lacrosse and for the city of Halifax.
Yeah, absolutely. So much buzz in the air. They've got a great pregame ceremony setting up behind us here, and I expect nothing but excitement inside this arena tonight.
And the game returns, at least professionally, to New York at the same time.
Yeah, returns to New York. They'll have their home opener in a couple of weeks, but lots of fans on Long Island and in that New York area very excited to have a pro indoor lacrosse team coming their way. Well, it is their way, but first they're going to watch on the road, and then I think in a couple of weeks back to Long Island. But I know the excitement is there as well, Pete. Lots of buzz in that area. You're going to see that arena with a good crowd here as well, but I can't get over what we've got behind us here. This crowd has been loud. We saw them last week at that inner squad game. You don't usually see big crowds to watch a team play amongst each other, and we saw just that here in Halifax.
Let's talk a little about the coaches. Mike Kersey, we'll start with him with the Halifax Thunderbirds here. Assistant coach, a great player in the league, a Hall of Famer, but his first time behind the bench as a head coach.
Yeah, lots of experience as a player and an assistant coach, but he's got the reins now, and he's going to be leading this Thunderbirds team behind the bench, and he's very excited. We talked to him a little earlier today, and he's looking forward to everything. He's very focused. You can tell it's game day with him, and very excited for him and the Thunderbirds today.
All right, what about the keys to the game?
Yeah, a few keys to the game. We're going to start with the New York Riptide. They've got a couple keys. They got to get off to a very early start. This crowd is going to be rocking, as we talked about. A couple quick goals is going to silence them early. They also have to stay disciplined. We've got a power play on the Thunderbird side that's been playing together for quite some time, and a new penalty kill. These guys aren't familiar with each other, so they just got to make sure they stay disciplined, because you don't want to be killing too many penalties against this Thunderbird squad. On the other side for the Halifax team, well, they need to get off to an early start and stay focused. We talked about that crowd. Well, that could be a deterrent against them. They could come out with too much energy fired up by this crowd. So they can feed off the crowd. That's fine. They just need to stay focused and relaxed on the floor. They also need to get off to an early start, jump on this team. Their offense needs to apply pressure early. They need to try and rattle this Riptide defense, who is just getting familiar with each other.
All right, there you have it. Should be a great one here tonight from Halifax. It is the NLL on BR Live. The NLL on BR Live is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. And by Alterna Bank, Canada's end-to-end digital bank. Alterna puts the good in banking. Visit alternabank.ca to learn more. And welcome back inside here, the Scotiabank Center in Halifax, Nova Scotia. It's Pete Dalladay along with Scott Arnold and Dana Jackson. And Scott, this is obviously a very special night here in Halifax, as right now we get to watch the opening a medicine wheel ceremony, which is really neat to see community members, family members all taking part in that here tonight.
It was very cool. We just saw the mayor on the big screen as well, welcoming lacrosse to the city of Halifax, and very big deal for this community. First pro lacrosse game to take place in Halifax, as we mentioned. We talked about the energy and the excitement in this arena. It is quiet now as the lights are turned down, waiting for a great pregame ceremony. That's white tarp laid all over the turf. So they're going to have some sort of light show. I know all the fans were given bracelets that light up. They're in their seats, so something as exciting is about to happen here in terms of this light show. I haven't seen a production like this at a lacrosse game before.
Yeah, really, it's going to be quite the show for sure, and we'll be seeing some of it. And it's just this whole journey started, months ago, Scott, with a paddle that ended up here. A canoe paddle all the way right here in Halifax. That's quite the story, too.
Yeah, Kurt Stiers, when he was new, he was relocating the team to Halifax. He took a three-month canoe journey starting from Six Nations all along the water to get here. It was a pretty great journey. A lot of people joined him along the way. And what a great way to bring lacrosse out east.
Yeah, we had a chance to have a good chat today with Kurt about that. And some of the players took part, Mike Akerzi, some of the staff, with the Halifax Thunderbirds, and certainly something to see as we get to enjoy the show here before tonight's big game between the Thunderbirds and the Riptide. Well, quite the show so far here, Scott. I think we're in for more, though, here. This is just the beginning.
Yeah, it was pretty impressive. You see that at hockey a lot. I didn't know how they were going to pull that off when I heard there was going to be a laser show here with that green turf, but here they are. They were ready for it. From what I'm told, the Halifax Mooseheads hockey team tried this a few years back. That's where the laser show started out in Halifax, and now here we go. Another big team joining the Mooseheads in this arena. The Halifax Thunderbirds, of course. You see all the bracelets around the crowd. Those are all the fans. Those aren't just lights in the seats. That represents all the fans that are here tonight. A great crowd to kick things off. Scotiabank Arena. I talked to you earlier that I was out on the town, and I mentioned Argyle Street. I was also inside the square and a few other places, and it was so neat to see all those orange Thunderbird t-shirts and hoodies and all the people walking around getting ready for this game. And anyone we talk to, we are in our suits for a bit. People asking, hey, what are you all dressed up for? As soon as we mention lacrosse, oh, yeah, that's tonight, isn't it? Good luck. And this whole entire community is rallying behind Pete, and we're seeing it here right now. I'm in awe by this opening.
Yeah, absolutely. I think this community of Halifax is going to take a liking to it. And there is the owner and the general manager, Scott, of the Halifax Thunderbirds right there.
And Kurt Stiers just behind the mascot on the right with the glasses. And then there is the representatives of this Thunderbirds team. Chad Culp waving to the crowd there. Micah Kersey right beside him. And look at Billy D. Smith there.
Looking
He's
sharp.
Going for the sharpest dressed man in the league award. I like it.
I thought he had a cane there for a second, but I think he's just holding up a lacrosse stick.
So did I. I thought, wow, that's really stylish there, Billy D.
It was good chatting with him as well. Happy to see Billy D sort of continue with his lacrosse career. One of the best defenders. I wouldn't have wanted to play against him, that is for sure, Scott. But now just continuing with this franchise as an assistant coach.
He's one of the best guys in lacrosse. Everyone's good. I mean, I've never talked to a lacrosse player that has an attitude or has a chip on his shoulder. Everyone's very forthcoming with the interviews. They always give us their time, but Billy D's one of those guys who just stands out as one of the best guys in lacrosse. And look at this crowd. Tough to find an empty seat in this place, Pete, and it's so good to see when they had no lacrosse here before. They just started growing the minor system in the last few years, and now these kids that have been playing have all these pro athletes that they get to look up to. It's a very cool experience for them, seeing those kids in the lobby before the game, wearing the Thunderbirds gear and the colors and just the smiles on their faces. That's what it's all about, Pete.
And I think that's what's going to happen too in New York, Scott, on the Long Island side of things. And that's one of the reasons why New York was really excited to bring in a guy like Reggie Thorpe, who's going to be doing sort of the same thing as well down there.
Yeah, and you got a guy who lives in the area, so he knows what it's all about. He knows how big lacrosse can be. And we talked about the field lacrosse game in New York. It's a hotbed, especially in Long Island. These guys are going to be playing at a Nassau Coliseum, which is a very cool spot, and it's known for field lacrosse, but box lacrosse is coming.
All right, let's go downstairs and join some of the presentation, some of the player intros.
Forward number 28, Stephen Kehoe. Forward number 33, Austin Shanks. Defenseman number 34, Corey Becker. Eagle number 35, Peter Dubinsky. In transition, number 44, Colton Armstrong. Defenseman number 45, Luke Magnus. Forward number 47, Kyle Jackson. Defenseman number 68, Trevor Smith. Eagle number 78, Warren Hill. Assistant captain and on defense, number 4, Graham Hussack. Also on defense, assistant captain, number 37, Scott Campbell. And your Thunderbirds captain, number 88, forward, Cody Jameson. Thank you. singing the Star Spangled Banner. Please welcome Angela Dunn.
We're going to pause for the anthems, and then we're coming back with the Halifax Thunderbirds and the New York Riptide. It's the National Lacrosse League on BR Live. Welcome back inside the Scotiabank Center here in Halifax, Nova Scotia. I'm Pete Dalladay along with Scott Arnold. Dana Jackson's going to be down at the field level for us all season long here in Halifax. And we're looking forward to checking in with Dana in just a little bit. The crowd is ready to go. Both teams ready to go as well here. And, you know, this should be a great lacrosse game. We talked to some of the players, coaches, Scott. Of course, the league kicked off last week. With a couple games, you know, and it was a little tough for them to sit back and wait that extra week, but they're ready tonight for sure.
They are, and we keep talking about this crowd. They are certainly ready. It went from silent after those pregame ceremonies. All of a sudden, you heard all these boo birds. You look down, well, the New York team had just come out, and the entire crowd just started filling the air with boos. And from what I'm told, it was like that during the inter-squad game. Obviously not the boos, but the cheering. All the stuff that you want from your lacrosse fans. These fans are going to be very into this game as we take a look at the starting goaltenders for the New York Riptide. That is Alex Bouquet. And at the other end of things, we've got Warren Hill between the pipes for the Halifax Thunderbirds.
All right, so the Thunderbirds in their purples here tonight with orange and white as Warren Hill will head to the bench and just get a little bit of water before he gets back in between the pipes. I don't know if they're maybe waiting for some of that smoke to clear as well after the opening and, of course, official face-off as well at center floor coming up here too. The captain's coming out. Cody Jameson wearing the C here for the Thunderbirds.
It's pretty neat to see Dan McCray on the other side of things. Former captain of the NLL champion Calgary Roughnecks. He's going to be captaining this New York Riptide team. Kirk Stiers doing the opening ceremony.
We were talking about this earlier off air. You won't meet a nicer guy than Dan McCray. Just a real gentleman. And, of course, Cody Jameson as well, both deserving of the C's to lead their teams into this season here. As we get a little closer to the opening draw, there's a look at Cody Jameson. Getting the bucket on and ready to roll.
Yeah, Cody Jameson, been in this league a long time, a veteran. We talked to him about Billy D. Smith. We saw him, sharp-dressed man on the other side of the bench. Micah Kersey, he's played with as well. These are guys who were former teammates, former opponents of him. And now he has them behind the bench as mentors and leaders. And now for the face-off, Jake Withers, look out for him. For the Halifax Thunderbirds, arguably the best face-off man in all of lacrosse.
Against Ryan Fournier, he'll take the draw here for the Riptide. Michael Stone looks like he's gonna drop the ball here. One of the officials for tonight's game. Crowd's ready to go, we're ready, and here we go, it's showtime in Halifax. And the opening draw, here come the Thunderbirds, shot, they score! Take long. Jake Withers, the first goal in Thunderbirds history, wins the draw, scores the goal. It's 1-0 Halifax.
Well, just seconds after saying he is one of the most dangerous men in the face-off circle, Jake Withers, right after the referee's whistle is blown, able to win that draw off to the side. He picks up his own Lucy. He's the only one who knew where that ball was going. As soon as he knocked it out of the faceoff circle, he darted right towards it, right to the net, and there is the first goal in Thunderbirds history, and a souvenir heads to the bench for Mr. Withers.
10 seconds, that's all it took for the Peterborough native to get the Thunderbirds on the board. First goal in Halifax history there for the Thunderbirds squad. Of course, this franchise coming over from Rochester. But that may also, we'd have to check the record books, because the record books did come over, Scott, from Rochester. They brought all that history with them. That's got to be one of the opening, fastest opening goals in franchise history. That was quick. 1-0 Halifax. The fans are going to expect that every game now. Loose ball off the draw this time. Again, control here. It's Cody Jamison. Up in front, Armstrong shoots. Oh, he's just denied. Colton Armstrong. That would have been 2 in 15 seconds.
2 Peterborough natives in 15 seconds.
That would have been a record, maybe, for sure. The Riptide have it. Sort of settling things down now a little bit. Controlled by Gale Thorpe. Thorpe has it at the top. Moves it over here along the right side. As it's going to be a whistle down, it's going to be Halifax ball. Or is it?
Yeah, they're going to have a brief discussion here. Ecclestone taking his helmet off. There might have been some confusion between the two calls, and they're going to head over to the timekeeper's box and check out something as Ecclestone gets word from the timekeeper. 1-0 already. That got the fans out of their seats right off the bat. There's a look at veteran referee Sean Ecclestone. He's been in the league for a while. One of the better guys to wear the stripes. There's Stephen Kehoe, another veteran of this league. Good to see him back and healthy in that lineup.
So it will be Halifax ball. They got things sorted out, and they'll look to increase the lead. They lead it 1-0 to go by Withers. Here's Burke with it. Burke moves it across. Shot coming, and a save right there by Bouquet. Loose ball up for grabs here in the Riptide zone, and it's going to be Halifax coming out with it. They'll get a full 30 on the shot clock. Burke sets the play, and it is whistled down.
A moving pick on that far side. We've got a Riptide down. Slowly heading off to the bench is Mike Manley. He's in a bit of pain.
So New York with it. Another shot here tying things up. They'll work it from the top. Digby, there's a pick. Digby opens up now. Here's a chance. Air wires. Pass across by Dan Loma. Shot coming. That goes up and over the goal. Loose ball taken. Air wires. This shot catches a piece of the iron. Fans, you can enjoy that. Got a little excited there. So New York with it again with a full 30 to work with, so lots of time. Dan Lomas. Lomas. There's a little room here. He's looking. And here's an opportunity. Triple coverage. Great defensive work there by the Thunderbirds.
Digby, he got caught up by 2 Thunderbirds. Here comes Halifax trying to get their second goal of the game.
Armstrong moves the ball. There's the shot. Stop comes right back towards the crease. And it's going to be New York ball. All the way up the floor. Looking to get it here. McCray couldn't grab it. Halifax up the other way. All alone. Here's a chance. Shot. He scores. Austin Shanks.
Austin Shanks, the former Whippy Warrior. He gets the second goal of this game as the Thunderbirds take a 2-0 lead. A long pass from Bouquet. Doesn't make it all the way. Gets picked off one bounce, and a long pass down to Shanks. He had to catch that turn and fire as there's a defender coming at him off the bench in Andrew Suter. And just like that, 2-0 Thunderbirds.
So a great start, exactly what Halifax and Mike Akerzi was hoping for here. I'm not sure he expected a goal in the first 10 seconds, but every coach wants to get a lead early, and they got it. As the ball up for grabs here, and it's going to be Halifax ultimately winning this draw. This is Armstrong, Colton Armstrong. Second year in the league now. Does a good job on that loose ball. Jameson moves it in. He'll come in, create a little screen, and comes here in the near corner. It'll be played by Shanks again. New York recovers, and they will head up down inside Halifax. Zone on a two-on-one. Here's a chance. Shot! No! Denied. Warren Hill with a save.
Huge save by Warren Hill. That was the best opportunity so far for the Riptide. He was able to stretch out and keep the door closed.
Burke with it. Burke to Keogh. Keogh's looking to get it back to Burke. He does. Burke got some room, goes in, shoots. Rebound! No, it's waved off. No goal.
Crease violation. Riptide going to come back the other way, but that got the fans going. It looked pretty. Fortunately, it didn't count.
So New York here with it. Ball moved in by Thorpe. Thorpe will get it. Here's a shot there and a chance. Gibson, the first overall pick, just missing. As he has an opportunity, wouldn't that be something if he could score the first goal in franchise history? Big hit along the near boards. Big collision. Manley coming in. Halifax with it. Up 2-0. Slow it down just a little bit. Jackson, Kyle Jackson. Oh, mishap there. Recovered here by New York. It's going to be taken here by Andrew Suter, the veteran. Tough customer, solid defender. Momus gets it. Momus, airwires. Airwires for looking to go one-on-one. He does. Now he gets some help, gets a little room, shoots on the short side. Misses. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Loose ball up for grabs. Long boat in the corner, but he's going to run out of time on the 30-second clock.
Good defense there by the Thunderbirds, killing off that 30-second shot clock.
And here come the Thunderbirds. Up by two already. Burke bounce pass across. Moves in a little deeper here. Cody Jameson over the top with the shot, and Bouquet with the save.
Looking for that five ball, Bouquet, though. And both legs close and a stick right there.
So a very good start here for the home team in their first game here in Halifax. And we will take another look at one, and we'll be back. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. Leading New York Riptide by a score of 2-0 here. Early action in the first quarter. First ever game here for the Halifax Thunderbirds. The Scotiabank Center. They couldn't have started any better.
What a great crowd they are too. The reactions from them. I thought they'd be maybe a little unfamiliar with the game of lacrosse, which I'm sure they are, but obviously you get the concept of it. When good plays happen, they're cheering, they're booing. That big collision we saw against the glass, they were awing. This is going to be a great season here in Halifax.
So, Halifax out to this 2-0 lead, and now New York with a chance to cut it in half. Dan Lomas. Lomas starting out and gets the ball here over center, cradling it, and now scoops it here into the stick of Ricardo. Over by Longboat, comes across to the near side. Bardo again, now to the top. Here's a shot coming up and over the net. Thunderbirds ball, Armstrong. Takes a bit of a high stick, but fights off the check. And the right-handed shot transition player will bounce it across and head over for change. Burke with it. Now down low. What a pass attempted by Jackson. I thought perhaps he was going to finish it off. He was looking for Benesh. They couldn't connect. Dan McCray. Will do the same. He will get rid of the ball and then head to the bench for another offensive player to come out. 2-0. New York trailing. Hairwires over to the far side. Pick set. No shot, another pass, 3 seconds on the shot clock. There it is, right on goal, but that's handled by Warren Hill.
Kieran McArdle just trying to reset the clock at that point, but no rebound coming from Hill.
Here's a chance, Shanks. He's looking for Jameson. Jameson might get it back after all he does. Thunderbirds captain, one hand on the stick. Got himself in deep right now, a little trouble. He's gonna need a little help from Vinesh. Gives him a little room. Jameson to Shanks, and Shanks to the top, shot, and a nice save right there. Good stop by Bouquet, it was a little tougher than maybe it looked.
Kyle Jackson looking for that five hole from the outside, but Bouquet, he's been closing the door on that hole.
Brooker Muir passes the ball off. He's gonna get it here to Connor Kelly. Kelly, Dan Lomas. He can score with the best of them. Lomas passes it over. Play is set, shot, got picked off somewhat, ended up in the corner, and it's whistled down.
And up and out of play, last touch by the Riptide, Halifax ball.
So Gillies with it. Keo. Halifax up by a pair. Keo passes it over to the far side, another quick pass. Good defense here by the Riptide. Halifax. 9 seconds on the shot clock to work with. Vinesh moves it over. Here's the shot, they score! Fennell took the pass. They were running out of time, but it's 3-0 Halifax.
Eric Fennell from long distance is able to beat Bouquet, and it is 3-0 with 7:19 left to go in the first quarter. Ryan Vinesh doing all the work here. One hand on the stick. Finds a hole to pass it through, and waiting as Eric Fennell takes one step into it, right into the back of the net, and this arena keeps rocking here as Alex Bouquet shaking his head, wondering what is happening here early. Certainly not his fault. He is getting peppered.
So I got another battle between Fournier and Withers here. Look at that. Jake Withers. It's making it look easy that time around for sure. Here's a pass across. Shanks was heading towards the net. Just couldn't connect. And New York with the ball. Moved up the floor. Ratzkiewicz passes it in a little deeper. And New York will start the play from in deep. There's a pick coming. Ball moved across. Ricardo. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Carl still with it, pushes it off, running out of time. In fact, they did. Shot clock expires.
Airwire's mixing it up behind the play right now.
There's a bird chance, and he just misses. Vinesh picks up the loose ball. Lots of time on the shot clock here for Halifax. Mike Burke with it. Burke rolls towards the top, gets the ball deep into the corner. Cody Jameson. Jameson backhand feed. And a spin move out in front. More to stay out of the crease. Here's a chance. Right there, score! Ryan Vinesh. 4-0 Halifax.
You can't leave most guys all alone on the doorstep, but you especially can't leave a guy like Ryan Vinesh. He's going to score every single time when you give him an opening and leave him that much room. Look at the hard work behind the net. Jackson gets the ball. Jameson with the one-handed dish out to Vinesh. Here's a great look at it. Right into that top corner as Alex Bouquet tried to slide over and close the door. 4-0 here. 6 minutes still left to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, some time here. New York wants to get one sooner than later. There's no question about that. Reggie Thorpe wants to end this run at four and try and get the first goal here in franchise history as the draw is won here again by Jake Withers and now it's Graham Hossett.
Vinesh.
He's got it looking for another one. Vinesh, he's got some room to shoot, decides try to feed it at the top of the crease and a big collision there. And loose ball, there's a big hit.
Wow. The crowd in the corner. corner on their feet. They're loving the collisions here. You see the big hits with the Halifax Mooseheads, but they have not seen collisions like they have tonight, I guarantee you that.
Play started by Connor Kelly. Now in for Lomas, but Mitchell's whistling down.
Moving pick at the top.
Here come the Thunderbirds. Played right here by Luke Magnus. Jackson is out there. Keogh's got it right now. There's the pass. There's the shot. And a save by Alex Bukin. Loose ball as New York takes it up the floor here. It's going to be McCray. Brand new turf here in Halifax. Looks sharp. Ball is going to be played here. Halifax will get rewarded the ball. 4:47 left here in the first quarter. All Halifax so far. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. Halifax Thunderbirds leading here, the New York Riptide. Let's go downstairs to Dana Jackson with the head coach of the Halifax Thunderbirds.
Coach, you told me your emotions earlier this week. This day felt like it was coming forever. What's it like now that you're out here coaching?
It's exciting. You know, we were off to a good start. You know, lots of game left to play, but the boys are playing well right now, so we're good.
Good luck in the second.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, Dana, and great chatting with Mike McCursey today. You know, we've seen him just go on to a great career as a player, and perhaps now, obviously, his coaching career is off to a good start, too, Scott.
It is, yeah, and you notice some of his players on the bench there. There's about three of them leaning in. They really wanted to hear that interview.
See what the coach had to say. Yes, indeed, all good so far. Here's Shanks. He'll get the ball here. Kyle Jackson out in front. Jackson was going to the net, but play broken up by New York as they will head up the turf here. It is going to be played by Rannigan. He looks, shoots, so oh, and a save there. Warren Hill's been fantastic when called upon him.
Warren Hill, he hasn't been too busy, just his fourth save, but all four of them have been good ones.
Here's Mike Burke, the native of Brampton, Ontario. Vinesh coming in to create a little room. Jameson moves it over to Burke. And Burke swings it over, penalty coming up, a shot just missed. And New York's gonna get the first penalty of the game, Scott.
It's gonna be a roughing penalty, so 2 minutes is gonna go up on the board here. And we talked about one of the keys to the game is New York needs to stay disciplined. Here you have a Halifax team. It's a relocated team, so all of these guys have played together in game situations on the power play. And although a few of these Riptide have been involved in penalty kills, not together and not in game situations together. So we will see if Halifax can pick them apart and take advantage.
Yes, these Thunderbird players, the five that are on the floor right now, there's a quick shot, know each other very well. Here's Vinesh. Jameson to Burke. Burke again gets it. Jameson, the captain, at the top to Burke. He's got room. Comes in, shoots it, a save. Ball goes up and out of play. That means Halifax will get it right back here.
Great play by Tyson Bomberry to get a stick on that one.
Jameson. He'll work the top quarterback it, if you will. Shot, bounce, and they score. Burke from Jameson makes it 5-0 Halifax.
Cody Jameson relaxed at the top, quarterbacking the power play. Over to that shooter position to Burke, and a bounce shot, if you ask any goaltender, is the hardest save to make. You don't know where it's coming up from, and Mike Burke, all the time in the world. Bomberry was there. I don't think he was screening Bouquet. I think Bouquet had a clear look at it, and just a perfect placement by the veteran Burke.
You can see assistant coach Billy D. Smith on the bench in the background. They're just nodding their head a couple times. Yep, that's the way to do it. So a power play marker makes it 5-0 here for the home team. Jake Withers looking to win another one here. Fournier trying to solve them, trying to figure it out. As Scott mentioned off the top, Withers one of the best in the business, if not the best. And he wins that one, goes back and grabs it, gets it off to Hossack. Hossack, he's got some good hands, shoots, just misses. He's known for his defense and being a tough customer, but he can put the ball in the net as well. He just showed us there that he's very capable of doing that. He just came about an inch or two away from making it 6-0. New York with it. Later stages of the first quarter here. Shots are 13-4 in favor of Halifax. Everyone getting a touch here for New York. There's a shot coming, goes wide of the net, goes all the way back to the New York zone. Halifax getting up. Gillies shoots, he scores! Brad Gillies, 6-0 Halifax.
Tough line change for the Riptide. Bit of confusion on the floor. They went for a line change, and Halifax was already streaking down. All they had to do was pick up the ball, head down. Luke Magnan right at the end. He causes that traffic in front of the net, allows Gillies to get that shot. Nice ball placement. Luke Magnan, though, creating that opening. And another goal here for the Thunderbirds in the first quarter.
Yeah, only 2:38 left. Draw one here by the Thunderbirds, and again, they'll get a chance to set up here on offense as Armstrong gets it to Keogh. Burke with it. Burke, Jameson out in front, and good recovery. Burke gets it again here for the Thunderbirds. There's the pass, there's the shot, and a save by Bouquet. Rebound goes up and over the goal, ends up in the near corner. Battle forward here. Keogh trying to come out of the corner with it. Cannot. And New York up the other way. They got 2 minutes to work with here to try and get at least one here in this opening corner. And this is Gale Thorpe. Thorpe, a little give and go. He gets it back. He looks, fires, ends up going at a play off a Halifax stick. So full 30 here for the Riptide. Here's a chance there and a nice save. Ward Hill with a beauty. Fans applauding his efforts. He's only faced the 5 shots, but that perhaps the best save of the night for him.
Yeah, there's only been one that was shot right at his chest when the Riptide were looking for a reset, but the other 4 shots, good quality scoring chances. He's had to stretch those legs out a couple times tonight.
Well, the Thunderbirds here, up by half a dozen. They come in looking for lucky 7. A good look by Jameson. That was an off-the-mark bunch. Burke. Swing pass, out in front, Shanks scores! Top corner, Austin Shanks.
Great ball movement by the Thunderbirds. Mike Burke was just trying to get it down low. There was only 3 seconds left to go on the shot clock, so he just fired it in to Jackson, hoping he could maybe relay it in to reset the clock. And instead, Jackson relays the ball right into the stick of Shanks, and with 1 second to go on the shot clock, Shanks finds the back of the net, his 2nd goal of the night.
Okay, down.
Yeah, big
Find
number
line.
33 has a couple. He's a native of Scarborough, Ontario.
Back.
So it's 7-0 for Halifax. Withers on his belly, still able to tip it ahead here a little bit for Graham Hossack. Hossack with it across to the far side. Here's a little fake. Another fake in Jameson. Just missing.
What a save by Bouquet getting a stick on it.
The veteran showing patience there. He could have fired it the first time, but fake, another fake, and he just missed. Play whistled down. New York's going to get possession of the ball here.
An interference possession call gives things back to the Riptide.
Just under a minute to go here in the first quarter. All Halifax, will see if the Riptide can get one here. A little fake play there. The ball is moved in a little deeper by Tyler Digby. Now comes to the near side. Ricardo heading to the net. Gets pushed in the crease. It's whistled down. It's Halifax ball.
Right into the crease just in front of Warren Hill, who had to take a brief step back to make sure he didn't get plowed into.
Colton Armstrong. He gets the ball here. They'll pull the goaltender here for the extra runner.
shot clock and the game clock pretty much match, so you're going to see Halifax just working around the outside, trying to kill off enough of that clock so that they don't get scored on that empty net.
Yeah, they'll wait till about 2 seconds maybe to take a shot. There it is. It goes up and over the net. Vaness shoots. Oh, he rips it off the crossbar. Shanks put his hands up. He thought maybe perhaps it went in or it was time left, but what a start here in Halifax for the Thunderbirds. After the first quarter, they lead at 7-0. There may be a bit of a review here. We'll wait and see, Scott. Maybe not.
I would ask for it. I don't think they can challenge that one at this point in time. The referees, I think, had the right call there. That went hard off the crossbar. I don't even know how he got it past Bouquet on that shot.
It is 7-0 for the home team. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. VR Live makes watching live sports easy. Download or visit to watch all of the National Lacrosse League action and more with VR Live. And a welcome back inside the Scotiabank Center. Pete Dalladay along with Scott Arnold and Dana Jackson here tonight. And it's been all Halifax so far, Scott, after one.
And we saw the opening of the game. Jake Withers win the faceoff, score in the opening 10 seconds. Let's see what happens here to start the second quarter.
Yeah, the two teams switching ends, of course. So we'll get a different look. Closer, better look at Ryan Fournier here and the battle that he has to deal with every single faceoff. And again, this one is won by Halifax. Graham Hossick with it. He's from Guelph, Ontario. And the ball moved in deep here by the Thunderbirds. Cody Jamieson with it. Jamieson. Over to the far side. Wants to cut through the middle, can't get through there. Comes over here, Jackson shoots. He's denied. Battling to try and get that ball back. And he does, Jackson scores! What a goal! Highlight reel material right there, not just a loose ball, and then he scoops it, throws it into the net. Fantastic, making it 8-0.
Well, a great effort, just as it looked like the Riptide. We're gonna come back the other way with possession. Kyle Jackson with some great work right along the boards. Alex Bouquet, the goaltender, comes out, and that's when Jackson capitalizes, swinging it right around.
Yeah.
Highlight reel goal, the best one of the night so far. That gets these fans going. Alex Bouquet just inches away from intercepting that, but Kyle Jackson was a bit quicker.
I mean, the goal was fantastic, but grabbing that loose ball the way he did with one hand on a stick. I mean, that's just pure strength right there. That's,
and to have the mindset to drive to the net as you're scooping up that loose ball with one hand. Phenomenal goal.
Yeah, I think you're going to see that a few times for sure on some reels. Here's Jamieson. Jamieson, Keo. We're going to set that pick. Comes back. Jamieson was waiting for it, but it's intercepted. And the whistle goes. There's going to be a penalty coming up here.
Manly,
we
got
to go to the Thunderbirds. So we saw a power play earlier against the Riptide. Halifax scored very early, and now they're going to get a penalty of their own. It's Eric Fennell, who already has a goal here tonight, heading off to the box. Just a bit of a low cross check on the back there. The Riptide will get to set things up, their first man advantage. We talked about their penalty kill, never been in a game situation. Well, of course, the same goes here for the PP.
Let's see if they can get on the board here on this man advantage. Digby. Haywires. Digby, Haywires again. Comes to the near side. Gibson. Wearing the number 19 his dad wore for many years. That's the ball taken here. Campbell's going to get it, the veteran. Get off the floor and see what Halifax can do, killing off his penalty. Jackson's coming off that great goal with the ball right now. Jackson with it.
Thunderbirds penalty to number 43, Eric Fennell. 2 minutes.
Swings it over. Shot from over the top.
Time of the penalty.
Save right there.
Steve Akeel, one of the tougher players in lacrosse, still managed to get that shot off as he's being hauled to the turf.
Early second quarter action, 8-0 Halifax leading. First game here at the Scotiabank Center for the National Lacrosse League. There's some ball movement here on this power play here for New York. Little fake shot, the save by Hill. And the ball controlled here by the Thunderbirds. They'll head up the floor. They'll move it ahead. It's taking their time. Hossack gets it to Jameson. Jameson moves it in a little deeper. He's happy to cradle the ball here, kill off some time. Now he passes over to the far side. Comes back here to Jackson. Fakes over the top, shoots. He saw a little bit of room there, Scott.
And he almost found it. Squeak it in. That was close. What a shot over top of traffic.
Well, good stop there by Bouquet. And now New York with an opportunity. Only a few seconds left in the power play, though. Digby. To Gibson. Gibson trying to get open. There he is. He shoots. And just misses it. And then he scoops it in. Is it going to be called a goal? It is. There it is. Tyson Gibson first goal in New York Riptide history. Grab that one.
The first overall pick with the first goal in franchise history. That's only fitting. And what a goal it was. Great pass from the far side. Scoops up his own rebound. And then that dive through the crease as Warren Hill was trying to get back in position. He was down and out on the far side. That's a veteran goal right there by the rookie.
Okay, down, find the line.
Yeah, there you have it, the first ever pick of the New York Riptide. And the first ever goal. And no doubt, family pretty proud of that one. Dad, Darryl. That's great stuff.
Penalty right off the face off here, Pete. So Halifax is going to go to work on a power play unless they score here, of course.
Jameson moves it over. Here's Benesh. Benesh back to the top for Cody Jameson. Nice pass, shot. It goes on the glass. Benesh grabs it. He tries to flip one over to the far crease for Shanks. Jameson, Shanks. That went off his stick. Still, penalty. Off the head. What a pass. I've never seen it. My goodness, Austin Shanks.
Austin Shanks, he's got a pair of goals here tonight. He was trying to get an assist in the best way he knew how. A little soccer headbutt. Right on the money. You don't see that too often. He was ready for it. He knew he couldn't get his stick back and saw the ball. Thought, hey, let's try this out.
I've seen a lot of things in the game of lacrosse, and so have you, Scott. I've never seen that. Soccer and lacrosse doesn't mix up all that often. You don't meet too many people that play both, but it looks like he has a little bit. Had that led to a goal, that would have been incredible. But still, nonetheless, impressive. Jameson, some movement now. Jameson has it. He fires. He just misses. And the ball goes off a loose ball in the crowd for a fan coming in from Wolfville. Scoops that one here tonight. And Halifax getting it back. Full 30 here now.
Jameson.
Shot! Oh, off the crossbar.
He's got a rocket that almost went into the top corner.
Jameson gets it back. Jameson. Benesh shoots. That was blocked. Comes over to Burke. Burke to Jameson. Back to Burke. Walks in. Decides not to shoot. Jameson at the top. Down to the crease. And New York getting a stick on that one. I think Gale Thorpe now. Force back into the crease, in and out, and it's going to be Halifax ball.
Andrew Suter with a nice effort, but he gets knocked back into the crease, giving the ball back to the Thunderbirds.
Jameson, Benesh shoots, he fires, and then it went off Suter again. And it's going to be a chance here for the visitor's shot. Oh, that hit the post, it bounces the right way for Halifax. They're getting all the bounces as well tonight. You gotta make your bounces, they say.
Step it on the ball. We're going
play
for
whistle down. It's gonna be Thunderbirds ball. 8-1, Halifax.
7-0 after the first period. The teams have traded goals here in the second.
Oh, Thunderbirds with it. Jameson. Burke, out in front, shot, just missing. And the loose ball taken here by New York, and here they come. We'll slow it down just a little bit. Double coverage here by Halifax, some solid D on the back end here for Halifax, creating the turnover, and that was Smith. The first good look at him there, Trevor Smith.
Fans appreciated his hard work. You can hear them, nice ovation as he went off.
Cody Jameson. Down low, Vinesh Jameson. Cross, trying to get it back to Vinesh. Jackson has it. Jameson down to the far crease. Shanks tries to find it, but broken up here by the Riptide. New York coming in. They're on the board now, trying to close the gap, trying to chip away. Down by seven here in the second quarter. Halifax getting the ball back. The inaugural game here in Halifax. Ball will be taken here in control by Halifax. Fennell, nice pass. Jameson fakes, shoots, and a save there by Bouquet.
Good opportunity. What a pass by Fennell. And Jameson, he gets stopped by Bouquet on the doorstep.
Manley with it. Manley to Digby. One-on-one. Backhand pass. Ends up in the corner. Grabbing it here. Bouchard out in front. And a quick shot and a save. And Halifax quickly in transition. Will head up the floor. Corey Becker from Lewiston, New York. And he gets the ball and it's controlled here. Jackson walks in, shoots. Bouquet with the save. He's faced 23 shots already here tonight.
Yeah, most of them were in that first quarter. He was busy.
Gibson has the only goal so far here for New York. Digby rolls off a check and flips the ball. There's the shot goes high. And taken here by Halifax. Here they come, looking for more. Magnan. Pass off to Fennell. Fennell with it. He makes his way over here to a strong side. He walks in, he's got the room, he scores! Eric Fennell. Another one here, and it's 9-1 Halifax.
Fennell with his second goal of the game. And Halifax continues to run away with this one. 9-1 here in the second quarter. Nice hard work from Austin Shanks. He's going to pick up an assist to go along with his pair of goals. And Fennell, coming off a pick, uses the defender as a screen. Bouquet couldn't see that one coming. Watch Fennell just come across. Perfect screen, perfect pick, and a great finish.
A good look at the draw right there. It's going to be New York.
And they're going to say Jake Withers moved a little too early off that.
It is 9-1 Halifax leading, and you're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. It is 9-1 Halifax leading here in the second quarter. And we're going to go downstairs and join Dana, who's got Reggie Thorpe, coach
Thanks,
of
guys.
New York.
Reggie, obviously probably not the start you wanted to. You just got a goal from your number one overall draft pick. How do you build off that momentum?
You know, all the momentum's with Halifax right now. We're just going to keep battling. You know, it's going to be 40-3.
Awesome. Good luck in the second period. Guys?
All right, Dana. Well, we don't want to see that.
40-3. He's at least he's honest with how he thinks his team is playing right now. But lots of time for them to turn this around. Still 7:33 left to go in this second quarter.
So New York, they're in whites here tonight, looking to get one here to make it 9-2. Here's Gibson. Gibson got a little room. Moves the ball in behind the net. First goal in New York. Riptide history. Tries to get open. He does. He just couldn't take the feed. He just missed getting it into the stick. But they do pick up the loose ball. A shot. And battle for it here along the end boards, and Withers gets it here for Halifax.
Warren Hill, a big reason they have the ball right now, coming out of his net with that big shot.
Gillies gets it a little deeper. There's 20 seconds, lots of time to work some plays here from the shot clock perspective. Jackson. Fake Shanks very much involved. The play whistled down here. Penalty, I think, coming up.
There's going to be a holding call going against the Riptide, I believe. Or, sorry, against Halifax. And we're going to see the Riptide go to work on the man advantage. And this is the break they needed. Try and get some momentum. You heard Coach Reggie Thorpe when talking about momentum. He says they have none of it, even after that Tyson Gibson goal that we saw earlier. But this is a good opportunity for them to build and get their second goal. But a good penalty kill here on the other side for the Thunderbirds.
And there's a shot of number 28 in the box, Stephen Keel. Gibson will be in the shooter position here. He's got the ball right now. We're in that number 19, moves it over. Played at the top, shot, and Hill with a save rebound. And Lomas came right back to him. Gibson with it. Gibson moves it in a little lower, gets the ball again. Digby has it into Tyson Gibson. Gibson's got one, looking for another one here. Didn't score the first two goals in franchise history. A good chance he could. Here's Gibson running at a time on the shot clock. Gibson's got a little room, passes it across. Hill slides over, big save, rebound. Oh, New York can't buy one there. Play whistled down.
There's going to be an interference penalty, and New York is hot. Heading to the box is going to be Dan Lomas. He tries to argue that call for a couple seconds before jogging it off. Warren Hill with a fantastic save, sliding over to close that door. The way he kicks out that left leg, I've never seen another goaltender do that. He's absolutely phenomenal. And we'll have some four-on-four action for a minute 10 before Stephen Kehoe jumps out of the box to rejoin his Thunderbirds. So lots of floor space out there. Could be a big advantage for the Halifax. Lots of firepower on the floor in their offense right now.
Yeah, lots of room. Jameson, Jackson passes it over. Jackson gets it back. Now it's Jameson again. Cody Jameson, pass over to Shanks, got blocked. Will he get the ball off the carpet? He does. And he gets knocked down a little bit. Loses the stick, kicks it across. Here's a pass. It's Jameson out in front. Oh, and a save right there by... Oh, man. Another nifty sort of soccer play there, Scott.
The Thunderbirds seem to be doing it all here tonight. Everybody got a touch on that play. Three of them with their stick, one with the foot.
Here's Connor Kelly. Kelly moves it. Opportunity, a chance. It goes wide. Shot taken right there by Gale Thorpe. And it's going to be taken by Halifax right by their bench. Corey Becker with it. Becker heads to the bench after getting rid of the ball. And Ryan Benesch. Benesch has it. Benesch passes it over. We'll try and open up here, create a little room perhaps here for Fennell. Power play. Heel comes out. So now have Halifax with a chance here to get into double digits. For the meantime, New York with the ball. Gibson with it. Only 33 seconds left in the man advantage, so New York will be able to eat up most of that time here. At some point, Halifax may get the ball back and have 5 or 6 seconds left to work with. Loose ball taken here by Ricardo, and now Halifax does in fact get it back with a dozen seconds left on the power play. Thompson. Little Thompson gets off the floor and wraps one shot here on man advantage. Now it's come to an end. Lomas is going to go right into the play. He'll try and track down Jackson. Jackson gets away from him. He knew he was coming out of the box. Jackson with it in behind the net. Benesch down towards the crease. Out in front, shot and a save by Bouquet. Kay's been busy. 26 shots he's faced. New York up the other way, short side. That's off the mark. They do get the loose ball off the glass. Later stages here of the second quarter. Real good battle right there along those far boards. So three-on-three, small area game over there. Hossack thought about going in there, then he heads back. Time's just going to run out, so Halifax will get things under control here with 3:06 got left in the second quarter.
No, you touch it.
It is all Halifax for the most part, 9-1 for the home team, and you're watching the National Lacrosse League right here on VR Live. Welcome back. National Lacrosse League action here on VR Live. We hope you're enjoying the action here tonight. Pete Dalladay, Scott Arnold, and Dana Jackson with you here for the inaugural game here in Halifax. And the Thunderbirds lead this one by a score of 9-1 and look to get to 10 before the end of the quarter.
Austin Shanks, he's got a pair of goals to go along with an assist. Ryan Benesch has a goal and two assists. Jameson with two nice helpers. Kyle Jackson with a goal and an assist. Eric Fennell with a pair. So the scoring and the assists have been spread out through this Thunderbirds roster.
Cody Jameson, the captain here, will start with the ball. He'll start the playoff. Fennell has had a hot night here tonight. He'll get it over the far side. Jameson gets it back again. Cody Jameson gets a pick. Rolls off that. Still has the ball. Jameson into the corner. He'll look to get open here on the near side. In the meantime, Fennell with it. Fennell coming in, shoots, saw a little bit of room there. And Shanks will take it. And Shanks, they got a reset. Jameson, he has it here with 2.5 to go in the quarter. His pass went off the top of the head of the stick there, and it's gonna end up New York getting the ball back.
4, 5, 6, 7.
And they'll make their way across center in time, Scott.
Yeah, if anyone who's unfamiliar with the game, just tuning in to see what Halifax and New York are up to, these new teams. You got 8 seconds to get it across center.
Pass, fake shot, Hill with the save, Warren Hill. He's only faced the 12 shots, but just some big saves by Hill. Here's Campbell, shoots. He just misses there, Scott Campbell. Native of Ajax, Ontario, and a big hit there too as Graham Hossack hits his big body in front of one of the New York Riptide players and plays whistle down.
And again, you can hear this crowd react, the oohs and ahs every time there's a collision, especially against the glass, this crowd right into it.
Under 2 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Kyle Jackson, Jackson passes it into Ryan Benesch. Benesch, sharp pass over. He may get it back. No, it comes to Jackson instead. Jackson's got some room, shoots. Yeah, threw a bit of an off-speed shot there, hoping to fool Boutet. Ball's available and taken here. It's a great chance here, heading up the floor. Manley shoots, and a save by Warren Hill. And a partial breakaway from Manley. That's his 11th save of the night. New York able to drop the ball though, and they have a chance here to get one before the end of the quarter. Shot, they score! They do get one, makes it 9-2.
Heavy outside shot, and it is Connor Kelly, the Easton, Connecticut native. He gets the second goal in Riptide history. They're within 7, tough mountain to climb, but still an entire half left as you see Digby. He's patient. He's waiting for that perfect opening. He finds Connor Kelly, usually with a number reserved for goaltenders. He fires it past Warren Hill, finds the back of the net.
Yeah, you don't see too many out players wearing the number 1, that is for sure. But he has the second goal, as you mentioned, in the franchise. Tyson Gibson scored the first one, and it was a dandy, too. Here comes Halifax. Shot blocked, and Riptide coming down again with a good opportunity. A shot at Hill with the save off Rannigan.
John Rannigan, he's going to be one of the better players for the Riptide this season. He gets stoned there, though, by Hill.
Hossett, Fennell. Tony Jameson, tries to pretend he still has it, but Banesha has the ball in his stick. Hidden ball trick. Now Jamison does have it. He's going to wait things out here. Only 8 seconds left, so they'll just, again, like the first quarter, play for the final shot, and there it is, a save. They might get one more off here. And some solid D right there, down low in the crease by Gavin Gray. And a nice little pat on the back as well, Scott. That's kind of neat to see, though. Appreciation.
Yeah, no frustrations there. Said, hey, nice play, nice check, and we'll go into halftime with a 9-2 lead.
Yes, indeed. Before we do, I think we're going to go downstairs here. Dana's lining up somebody here down.
She's down there with Scott Campbell right now, I believe. They're ready to go. We'll throw it downstairs to Dana.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Scott Campbell down here. Scott, off to a great start in the first half. What was the environment like for you guys?
Oh, it was great. I mean, we scored that one early. Crowd got behind us, and we just kept rolling from there. It was awesome.
How do you continue to build off this momentum from the first half?
Yeah, I mean, these guys are obviously going in the room. They're going to come out flying. We just got to stick with their game plan, and everything should continue this way.
What do you think of the Halifax fans so far?
Oh, they're awesome. This has been a great atmosphere.
Good luck in the second half. Thanks, guys.
All right. Thank you so much, Dana. Yes, 9-2. It is Halifax leading, coming up the NLL at the half. It's been a big night so far here. Some great goals, and you're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. Welcome back, NLL at the half. It's Pete Dalladay along with Scott Arnold. And just quickly before we get back to the second half of our interview with the commissioner, a great start here tonight for lacrosse in Halifax, Scott.
Amazing start. The first goal coming 10 seconds in, and then a lot of goals following after that. Seven, in fact, in the first quarter. It's just been fantastic. It's been an exciting game here tonight. Exciting time for the league. Let's cut down to Dana with the commissioner, Nick Sukovich.
Now, I know a lot of people want to know what goes into finding the next expansion market. You know, why Halifax? What about Halifax and Nova Scotia made the NLL decide to put an a team there, not an expansion team?
Well, we really look at three things that must be in place, and that is a great owner, a great arena, and a great marketplace. And Halifax is such an underserved market from a major league professional sports standpoint. We have a great owner in Kurt Stiers that has been in our league for a very long time and actually has a penchant for putting championship teams on the floor. You have a great downtown arena in Halifax, and it's a city I fell in love with 3 years ago when I first met the mayor and the leadership there, president of the arena, Carrie Cousins. So it's a terrific downtown arena setting. And a town that is hungry for major league sports. So we think it has all the ingredients, great owner, great arena deal, and a vibrant marketplace to be successful.
What about New York? I mean, they're similar to Philly in that they're not necessarily, you know, brand new. They were around the National Lacrosse League previously, but it's almost a rebirth of a franchise, obviously, new name, new ownership. So did the same factors go into deciding that New York was going to be an expansion franchise?
Yeah, no different than Halifax. Great arena deal, which we have at Nassau Coliseum. Spectacular ownership in Gary Furman and Eric Baker and GF Capital coming into our league. And then, of course, market doesn't get any bigger or better than New York City. So lots to be excited about there. And we're happy to be finally back in New York.
Now, lastly, I have to ask, the people want to know, can you spill any details as to further expansion? Is there going to be a new team, a new market? I know there's always chatter out there. Can you give me or the fans any sort of details or crumbs?
I can say that we are looking to expand three teams over the next three seasons. Not this one, because we have two new teams coming in, but in 2021, 2022, 2023, one team each year. We have seven marketplaces that are vying for those three slots. There's a lot of interest, and people are really doing a deep dive into the NLL from an investment standpoint. We're also going to be very careful geographically on where we place teams, and the same criteria fits. Great owners in great arena deals in terrific markets. There really are no bad markets. There are just either bad operators or bad arena deals. We're raising the bar in terms of who we allow into the league and which arenas we play in.
I'd say that was more than a crumb.
No, that's a little bit. No names, I can't give you any names.
No names, no places, but that was a good answer. All right, Commissioner Skevich, thank you so, so much for joining me.
Thanks, Devin. Thanks.
All right, thank you so much for that as well, and Mr. Commissioner too. Exciting times for sure for the league. A great start here in Halifax. We got all your highlights coming up as NLL at the half continues. Stay with us, we're back after this. Welcome back to the NLL at the half. Pete Dalladay along with Scott Arnold and Dana Jackson. And a lot of goals in the first couple quarters. Scott, let's start to take a look at the Halifax goals, including a very early one.
Yeah, seven goals in the opening quarter for Halifax. Here's the first one right after Jake Withers had just won that faceoff, knocking it over towards the boards. He scoops it up 10 seconds in, and we have the first goal in Thunderbirds history. They kept things rolling. Here's that long stretch pass right down low to Shanks. That was his first of a pair of goals. He's all smiles. And then here we see the hard work from Ryan Benesch. One hand on his stick, goes over to the far side to Eric Fennell. He's able to get that off the carpet. Cody Jamieson getting into the action here. His first of a pair of assists, drops it over to Burke to find the back of the net. And the action just kept going Thunderbirds' way. Another big bounce for them. This time it's Brad Gillies. He's got a goal and an assist so far. That was his first point of the game. And then another bounce off the boards to Burke right away. A relay pass stretch in. Austin Shanks with his second goal, and he's all smiles once again. And then we see the highlight reel goal. Kyle Jackson, this was the start off the second quarter. Bouquet tried to reach for it. Kyle Jackson takes full advantage. And then here is the last goal from Eric Fennell. And I believe that was the last Halifax goal.
Yeah, they certainly started on a roll. Let's take a look at the first one in New York history.
Tyson Gibson, he gets things going. Highlight reel goal as well. He takes advantage of a bouncing ball and a misposition Warren Hill. A diving through the crease goal. The first goal in franchise history for the Riptides.
Yeah, and certainly, and we talked about that. I'm not going to say we predicted it, but we were chatting about wouldn't it be ironic if the first overall pick ended up with the first goal.
Yeah, absolutely, and sure enough, he did. What a great kid. We were talking to him earlier, and he was all smiles before the game. He's going to be all smiles now, despite losing the first goal. That's pretty cool.
All right, it's the NLL at the half, and this is not the only game that's going on tonight. Scott, there's a look at our halftime stats, and we'll get into some other scores later on. But 9-2, and a look at some of the shots as well.
Yeah, we saw so many shots there. 28 shots for the Thunderbirds. Most of those coming in that first quarter. 15 shots to the Riptide. And Warren Hill, he wasn't too busy, but he had to make some spectacular saves. We saw him slide over from post to post a couple times, kicking that left leg out. Very entertaining first half. We saw the Halifax fans, they were into it. Every time there was a good play, they reacted to it. We see Alex Bouquet, the opposing goaltender. Whenever he came into his net, you could hear the fans, "Book." You know they're into it when you hear stuff like that.
Yeah, we'll look forward to the third quarter coming up, and of course the fourth as well. You're watching the NLL at the half here from Halifax on BR Live. The NLL on VR Live is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. And by Alterna Bank, Canada's end-to-end digital bank. Alterna puts the good in banking. Visit alternabank.ca to learn more. 9-2 Halifax, an exciting first couple quarters to get things underway. Let's go downstairs, and Dana Jackson is down there with a special guest.
Thanks, guys. I'm with the captain of the New York Riptide. Dan, obviously not the half you'd wanted as a leader on the team. What was your message to the guys in the locker room?
We just want to get better, right? It's our first time all playing together in an atmosphere like this. Not the start we wanted in the first 5 minutes, but we saw the last part of the second quarter was starting to get better. So that's all we want to do is keep getting better every shift.
Thanks. Good luck in the second half. guys.
All right, thank you, Dana and Dan, for that. We're talking about Dan McCray. He's obviously not as happy right now, Scott, as he was when we were chatting with him earlier in the day.
No, it's still lots of time left. They just need a quick start, just like we saw Halifax get to start this game.
So here we go. The third quarter is underway. Another face-off win right there by Jake Withers, who scored 10 seconds into this contest. Jackson has it here for Halifax. Now Cody Jameson. Jameson, he drops it here for Ryan Vinesh. Jameson is open, there's the feed. Down to the crease, fake shot. Oh, a great chance there by Jackson. He already scored one, Dandy, already tonight.
And early in the second quarter, we saw him score one at the other end. Nice diving through the crease from behind the net goal.
Bomberry goes off the glass. He picks up the ball, gets it back towards the top for Tyson Gibson. And the ball off the glass on the near side, and good recovery there. Burke got hit pretty good. Still able to swat it. Now Burke has it, and Burke will get it up here to Thompson. We'll go Thompson with it. He takes a bit of a high stick there from Danny McCray. Playing a little on the nasty side here on the start of the third quarter. And Halifax with it. Jameson, shot coming. That is stopped. Here comes New York again, as we talked about in the half. Trying to chip away perhaps at this 9-2 Halifax lead. No doubt went over some plays during the half to try and make that happen. Turtle looks, got a good look too, but a save, and then comes to Turtle with Dan, rebound, it's there, there's a trickle in, no. Didn't cross the line.
Warren Hill lost sight of it. He turned around just to see that it had stayed inches outside that goal line.
Here's Armstrong with it. Colton Armstrong wearing number 44 here for the Thunderbirds. Trying to create some room. Over the far side out in front. Jackson couldn't reach it. Out Shanks behind the net. Backhand shot. Off the crossbar and up and out of play.
We've seen some great shots from Stephen Keough, and he tries a little bit of magic there behind the back.
Let's take a replay here, Scott. One that almost went in, or did it?
It's the last play there that Warren Hill lost sight of it. That's tough. It has to be completely across that goal line. There is still part of it on the white.
No challenge, so it's going to be played here by Dan Lomas. Lomas gets the play going. Thorpe with it. Over the far corner, 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Solid knee. There's a chance out in front, and Dan Lomas just missed. He doesn't miss often from that range, and he had an opportunity, but could not bury it. Oh, here comes Becker. Corey Becker cradles the ball, flips the stick a couple times. Got some room, he's got some time. It in a little deeper, now comes in the set of little pick and a backhand shot going wide by Fennell. Jameson has it. Jameson across, shot coming by Burke, and that is handled.
Alex Bouquet and the Riptide, they've recovered nicely. It was 7-0 after that first quarter. In that second quarter, it was 2-2, so a good recovery for them.
Well, he saw a lot of rubber thrown his way in the first couple quarters. Right now, though, Halifax with it, Armstrong. Armstrong for Shanks. Shanks gets the ball right back here from Jackson. Shanks shoots, low shot, and Bouquet with the save. Got down low, saw it well.
Shanks looking for that hat trick goal with a nice outside shot.
New York with it. Looking for their third goal of the night. Ball played here. The Gardel. Thornton. We'll move it across. Kelly coming in. Kelly's got one already, looking for another one. Cardinal shoots, and that goes wide on the short side. Ball's up for grabs. Gotta be whistled down. Halifax, though, with it, and here they go. Thompson. Thompson, 2-on-1. There's the pass across, a fake shot! And Bouquet with the save. Now down the other way. They'll get it up over center. McCray letting it go now. McCray will play it. McCray, a bounce shot, and a stop there by Warren Hill. Reset here for the Riptide. Their first ever game. Penalty coming up. Well, if they don't score here, they'll get a chance here. One way or another, Gibson with it. Gibson. Gives it over here. Lombard Gibson down low. There's a shot fired, and Hill again sliding over. He's able to kick it out to the far court. And a real battle for that ball down there to the right of Hill. It's finally whistled down. Things getting a little bit more on the nasty side here, Skip.
Lots of rough stuff. Things picking up as New York has certainly turned things around after that first quarter. Yeah. They're going to go to work on the man advantage now. They had the goaltender pulled. Lots of time there with the sixth attacker on the floor to try and get something going.
It is 9-2 Halifax. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on BR Live. On February 1st, the San Diego Seals are making history and hosting the Colorado Mammoth for the first NLL game to be played in Las Vegas. For more information, visit sealslax.com/Vegas. I wouldn't mind going out to that one, Scott.
Yeah, they'll need a broadcast crew for one night. Pretty cool, though, that they're stretching that way as we take a look at Eric Chanel in the box. New York's already 1-for-2 on the man advantage. We'll see if they can add to that right here. 7-goal deficit, but still, again, lots of game left, and they have that good second quarter just allowing two.
So, yeah, a good opportunity here. This is the time to try and get it done with that man advantage. Good ball movement. Everyone gets a touch. Hill gets a touch as well, though, as he comes over and makes the save. Play is stopped. Looks like New York will get it back with a full 30 on the shot clock as well to work with. At the top here of the power play, Digby from New West out in British Columbia. Puts it over here, Longboat. Now Digby again, backhand pass. Came over to the near side, grabbing it here, Lomas, and Lomas. Digby coming in. He breaks a little room. Big guy himself. Doesn't take much to do that. It's going to be played here. Halifax will get the ball. We still have about half of the penalty to try and kill off. Sort of twirl the stick a little bit. Austin Shanks. Keogh's out there. Keogh back to Shanks. Now the play sort of gets going. Pass ends up in the far corner. Keel picks it up and a bounce shot. Goes up off the end netting and back in play here.
Good effort by Keogh as he gets taken down to the turf again. Still manages to use his strength to get a shot off.
Bartle passes it over. 28 seconds to go in the Halifax penalty. Gale Thorpe. Startle down towards the far crease. Kelly now over to the near side. Thorpe. There's the pass. Having to grab it as Longboat. Shot from way out and a save there. There's only about a second left in the shot clock. Hill was there for the stop. Went up and out of play, so they'll get a reset again here. Power play's about to come to an end though. Another chance here to make a shot or two now. Fennell comes out of the box. Little fake shot and trying to go over the shoulder of Hill right there was Thorpe. But Hill, side coming. Good loose ball here by New York. Good tie with it. Thorpe waiting for a little screen. There's a shot on goal and Hill with the save. He's made 20 stops here so far tonight in this one. The Thunderbirds in flight here tonight as it's taken here by Burke. Burke's got room to move in. There's the pass. There's the shot. And good opportunity there, but nothing to show for it by Halifax. Rannigan grabbed it, got rid of it, heads to the bench. Out comes Digby. He always has the ball pretty much on every possession here at one point or another. Halifax will get it back. 7 minutes to go in the third quarter. First game ever of National Lacrosse League action in the city of Halifax. Unless you count that inter-squad game a couple weeks ago, Scott, that had this crowd rocking just for an inter-squad game.
It sure did. These two teams, right before they made their final cuts, playing against each other, essentially broken into two different teams, and the crowd was here just pumped. And now they get their first taste of official NLL action, and they've been right into it, right from the opening goal that was scored 10 seconds in.
Lacrosse is back in New York as well, which is fantastic to see. It's back in the Big Apple. They got a couple of goals on the board, but looking for number three here in the third quarter. Riptide with a shot, and Hill makes the save, and another chance, and that comes right off. Hill's going to put it back on. That's one of the great things about lacrosse. Goalies are pretty good that way.
What a save by Hill, down and out. And yes, has to fix his own net as the play goes back the other way.
Thunderbirds, they come down inside New York territory. There's the pass. Jackson tried to put it behind his back. It just came out of the stick as he went to do that. Burke has to hustle back here and play to defense. Hill getting another piece. Well, he's been a little busier here now in this third quarter than he was the first two. Great battle for the ball in that far corner. Some young fans behind the glass enjoying their lacrosse here tonight in Halifax. Coming in from Mahone Bay, perhaps. I think this whole province is really going to take to the game. Armstrong, he comes from a lacrosse hotbed in Peterborough, Ontario. He knows what it's like to play in front of the big crowds, and where lacrosse is big. Hopefully that is the case here. Halifax off to a great start. It's a rough, tough game at times. I think they're going to like that here too. Same thing in New York. They'll love it. We got the right guy behind the bench, Reggie Thorpe, leading the way. One of the best in this franchise, in the Halifax franchise, going back to his days with the Nighthawks. He beats a lot of their categories, Scott.
He does. Games played, loose balls, most penalty minutes.
There's a chance, great opportunity. Oh, man. Hill, great play all around.
Zach Hairwires found himself right on the doorstep, and Hill denies him.
Withers with a pass. Here's a shot, a stop at the other end by Bouquet. End-to-end action here at the Scotiabank Center. As the New York Riptide making their way down inside Halifax territory. Thorpe heading towards the top of the play. There's a chance. Connor Kelly denied of his second. And I think Warren Hill's becoming a fan favorite real quick here in Halifax.
He's showing his stuff here in this opening game.
Gillies gets the ball. Now it's Shanks. Little head fake. Passes it over. Fennell with it. He's had a big night here. He's been involved in a lot of action here. Offensively, physically. Another couple fakes and a shot. Trying to get it through was Benesh, but it was blocked by a defender. Riptide up the other way. Here they come. Fournier passes it over. Shot. And Warren Hill makes another save. Maybe not the toughest save you'll ever see, but you know, fans here at Halifax love it.
What's a goaltender's duel here in the third? No goals in this third quarter.
Yeah, they're putting on a clinic. You're right. They've been sharp. Here's Mike Burke. Burke with a pass. Keogh goes in. Just kind of lost the handle a little bit. And we get a whistle with 2:59 to go in the third. Halifax leading. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on BR Live.
Stay up to date on all the news, announcements, and exclusive prizes with the NLL newsletter. Sign up now at NLL.com. As we take a look at Warren Hill, who's been spectacular here, as has been the case on the other end with Alex Bouquet, but Hill has been fantastic, Scotty.
He's been busy in this third quarter as New York continues to apply pressure. They seem to be trying to go low on Hill. He's got that big body. It's tough to see those top corners, but every time they look for the five hole or a bottom corner, he's either got the stick there or that left leg to kick out. He's made some phenomenal ones, and there's Alex Bouquet at the other end. He's been spectacular. Bit of a rocky start for his team, certainly not his fault. He faced close to 25 shots in that opening quarter alone. He's been able to settle down and recover.
Yeah, low scoring. Well, obviously no scoring here in the third quarter. See if New York can get one here now as they start to play with the ball. Riptide. Lots of time still on the shot clock to work with, about 13 seconds. Lomas trying to get it out there for Tyler Digby. Here's a shot coming. That one way wide. Halifax look like they're going to recover the ball. They will. Graham Hossack, tough defender on the back end. Barkley, the Shanks. Here comes Austin Shanks. Shanks took a look, decided no, that wasn't the right play. Burke, he will shoot, and that is handled by Bouquet. Play though, whistle down, Scott.
Yeah, the Riptide got knocked back into their crease, so that'll give the ball right back to the Thunderbirds.
No opportunity here. They've been stuck at nine for a while. As Burke will bounce it down towards the far side. Burke gets it back. In deep, he comes in. Sets a little screen and a bounce shot, almost fooled Alex Bouquet, but it's going to be New York ball. That's a good win. He's going to cradle the ball as he makes his way down. And New York sets up the play here on the near side. Yale Thornton. Oh, a little bit of a miscue. Thompson almost had it, couldn't. And a sidearm shot right on net. And stopped by Hill. Thompson with it. Where will Thompson? Now over here to Keough. Stephen Keough. In for Burke. Burke down in the corner. Cody Jameson, that captain here in Halifax, rolls to get away from a check. One-handed pass over to the near side. Keough shoots, and that's saved by Bouquet.
Keough with his own rebound, though. He's had a couple good chances tonight.
So reset on the shot clock. Lots of time left here for Burke. And Burke controls it. He'll bounce it over the far side for Jameson. Jameson zips it over. Keough shoots a heavy shot right on net, right in that Riptide logo of Alex Bouquet.
That's all.
Up the other way. McCray out of front shot. Oh, a great chance there, Scott.
Air wires with a little bit of an underhand shot off balance. And almost managed to squeak it by Hill.
Still stuck at 9-2. Here's Campbell. Scott Campbell, a veteran here in the National Lacrosse League, an opportunity, and the ball ends up in the crease and hustling back to play it. Another veteran, Andrew Suter, moves it ahead. Brooker Muir from Welland, Ontario. And it's going to be the Riptide. The goalie pulled right now. Shot, they score! Great play, finished off by Dan Lomas. What a shot.
Dan Lomas, who's had a couple opportunities here tonight. He finds the ball with a wide open cage to look at after a great pass from that far side. Look at Tyson Gibson. He looks up at the clock, realizes only 4 seconds left to go, so he starts making his way down the middle lane, making the Thunderbirds think that he's gonna take the shot. And he sees Danny Lomas out the corner of his eye, scoops him the ball, and Lomas with that quick stick into the open cage.
You're absolutely right. That is a sort of a veteran move by a kid that's playing his first game in the league, Scott. Just had the composure to look up at the clock, see how much time was left, and the next thing you know, second or two later, the Riptide make it 9-3. So, yeah, that was a heads-up play as we're back.
watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. From around the National Lacrosse League this season on VR Live. Choose an annual, monthly, or per game pass. Visit NLL.com. So many games, so many great teams with an opportunity to, have a great year this year, Scott. And this is week two, and it's been great so far.
It certainly has. It's great with the expansion, adding two more teams this year. And they're both on the floor here tonight facing each other, which is pretty fitting to get this new season going for the National Lacrosse League. And pretty good treat these fans have had. 7-0 after the first quarter for their Thunderbirds. They were spoiled. And then the Riptide were able to turn things around. Just one goal to report in that third quarter. And it was from New York.
Yeah, that was it. Yeah, just the one. And it
came late. 7 seconds, yeah.
Almost a scoreless quarter, and that doesn't happen all that often. Rarely. And the ball ends up in the corner, so speaking of rare, sort of a rare loss there by the Thunderbirds on the draw. So we'll see if the Riptide can take advantage of that. Connor Kelly. Kelly moves it over out in front. Kelly looking to get it back. He does get it off the boards. Passes it. Digby into the crease. And it's whistled out. Hill gets the net readjusted. And the Thunderbirds get the ball back, leading it 9-3.
Riptide third goal. Scored by number 17.
Almost collided.
And it's just got its way.
Ryan Banesh, quick pass over.
Here's
Keogh.
One second of the third quarter.
Now it is Banesh. A little fake, trying to make his way in a little closer. Out in front, there's a shot and a save by Bouquet. He moves the ball ahead. As he'll get it down to the left side, and Suter has it. Suter bounces it off the carpet and into the stick here of Connor Kelly. Now it's into the far corner. Longbow. Kelly over the top, shooting it into the stick, stopped there by Hill. Hill moves it ahead and a good grab. Going up the floor. Here they come. Becker shooting it right on net. And Bouquet gets in front of that one. He's faced 45 shots here tonight. A bit of a high stick and they get called at will. And the Thunderbirds quickly pull the goaltender Hill for the extra shooter here. A little hidden ball trick. Withers. Puts it into the stick of Jamison. Jamison behind the net. Jackson couldn't grab it. And we get a stoppage of play with 13:01 to go.
And despite leading 9-3, the Thunderbirds have not scored since that first half. So we'll see if their power play can get things going. They had a nice power play goal earlier on in this game. Off a dish from Cody Jamison. He's going to quarterback this power play once again. We'll see some great ball movement once again on this PP. There's the high stick. Fans reacted to that right away. So did Withers.
So on the power play, the Thunderbirds work the ball. Cody Jamison passes. Finish! Just missing on a bit of a quick stick. And Burke trying to prevent his man from gaining the zone, but here's Peterson. Low. New York down 9-3. Good time for a shorthanded marker. As they have the ball controlling it here. Suter, one option, but now a shot towards the net. Halifax getting it back. Up the floor they go. Graham Hossack. Hossack waits for all the offensive players to get out and get into position here, and they'll set up the power play as New York sets up the box. Jamison wires one right on net. A heavy shot, and Bouquet got a shoulder on it. They'll get a full 30. Finish. Jamison at the top of this power play. Cody Jamison now towards the crease. Jamison coming in, shoots. Actually, May went off an esh. His own player there out front. Got blocked one way or another. And here's Andrew Suter. He'll be one of the leaders here, Scott, with New York this year.
He certainly will, on and off the floor.
Travis Longboat gets it there to Gale Thorpe. And now again, along the near boards, Connor Kelly flipping the stick a couple times. Trying to get away from Thompson, shoots, good shot too. Hill had to be careful there to make the save.
Yeah, Hill seen it just at the last second. Looked like it was gonna go into that top corner.
Will Thompson here for Ryan Benesch. Jamison wants it back, he gets it, and then kind of started shooting or heading out before he had it, but it's a nice job to recover. Penalty is up, backhand shot, stop, rebound. And behind the net, Kyle Jackson. He does some of his best work back there. Jackson, Benesch. Lots of touches here, lots of ball movement here by the Thunderbirds. At this point, I guess, Scott, I don't know what your theory is. Do you want to use up most of the 30-second shot clock at this point? Up by six.
You're certainly in no rush, so might as well kill the clock, especially the way New York has been playing these last 2.5 quarters.
Ryan Fournier from the nation's capital, Ottawa, Ontario. Played nearby, Connor Kelly. Just over 10 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. 9-3 for Halifax. The inaugural game here in Halifax. On this Saturday night in December. Shot went off the carpet, then went off Hill, and then went off the glass, and it's gonna be recovered here. And the Riptide get it right back, and they got a full 30 after all that was said and done. They're moving the ball here. Tough D. Talked a lot tonight about Halifax's offense, but some solid defenders on that back end too.
They did a good job there, containing the Riptide to the outside.
Oh, we get a whistle here, 9-3. It's Halifax leading New York. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. Time for the save of the game presented by Alterna Bank. Let's take a look, Scott.
He's been busy here tonight, and here's a huge save by Hill as Manley with a clear break. He's a couple steps ahead of the closest man, and watch Hill. He just keeps his composure, stays patient, waits for the shot to come, and closes the door. And that is our Alterna Bank save of the game.
Yes, indeed. He has made 33 saves here tonight, 39 at the other end for Alex Bouquet. There's a guy that's been busy here tonight, Scott.
He certainly has, and a tough start. And again, it wasn't his fault, those 7 goals in the first quarter. The Thunderbirds came out flying, so many shots off the hop.
Thunderbirds starting to play here. Benesch has the ball for Halifax. A shot and a stop. Bouquet, rebound, reset on the shot clock. There's a pass, another stop. He's got it. He needs some help there. Suter came in and he sort of saved it from crossing the line, Andrew Suter.
We've seen that before. Suter getting into his crease, making the saves. This time he just traps the ball.
I think if they needed a third goaltender, he'd go in.
He'd jump in front of anything.
When he needs the pads, maybe. Just under 9 left here in the fourth quarter. Digby, nice pass, shot at Hill with another stop. Oh, man. Mentioned back in the second quarter, he is becoming a fan favorite early with this Thunderbirds crowd here in the nest. Jackson with it. He's doing some great grassroots programming here. He's living full time in Halifax. Working with some minor lacrosse, moves the ball across, and getting an arm on that was Bouquet. Jackson says, I'll take that, thank you very much. Grabs DeLucy, gets the ball back here in the corner. Kyle Jackson, Al Shanks, ball movement here. There's a scoop pass over towards the far crease. Halifax still with a chance, a one-hand underhand shot. As Shanks is looking. Here's Jamison, he's denied.
He's gonna get called for the crease anyhow, but a good opportunity as Cody Jamison scooped that up almost with a clean shot.
Oh, New York here. Again with an opportunity here. I mean, they have kept Halifax to nine here. They've got the only goal of this second half, if you will. A shot coming, and a man caught a piece of the iron. He'll got a piece too. Hossett coming in. Drops it, shot, they score! Halifax gets into double digits. Corey Becker. And grab that ball, it's a souvenir for Corey Becker.
That is Halifax's first goal of the second half. After putting up nine in the opening half, it took them a while to solve Alex Bouquet. And off a quick transition, nice little give and go dish, a little screen in front, and Becker with the nice finish. And he'll keep that ball, as Pete mentioned, as a nice souvenir.
Well, 10-3 now, Halifax. Took them a while to get that 10. Here's a chance off the draw, Withers! He scored off the opening faceoff of this game. 10 seconds in, almost got his second of the night. Jake Withers, a faceoff specialist, but he does have some pretty good hands as well when given the opportunity off those draws. Missed his second of the night. Halifax with it with 17 seconds left in the shot clock. Ganesh moves it over to Shanks. He finds some rooms. He makes the shot. A Bouquet with the save. Rebound retrieved here by the Riptide. Lacrosse, professional lacrosse back. The box lacrosse style in New York, which is fantastic. Reggie Thorpe and his crew will no doubt do a great job there, growing the game there and bringing the excitement back to Long Island. Here's a chance, and a go in. Yes, indeed. It's a good goal. And the Riptide have made it 10-4, a beauty by Dan Lomas.
Lomas picking up his second goal of the game, and this time doing it in style. He set up behind the net from a standstill position to a Superman dive, tucking that right into the top corner. No chance for Warren Hill, and you see Hill, right after it goes in, look at the referee to see if it was a clean goal. And the Riptide continue to apply pressure. It's too little too late at this time, but they have certainly finished the game respectable, and a lot of positives to take out of this one. Still 6 minutes left, but scoring six goals on Warren Hill, and this Thunderbirds team's gonna be tough. Not counting them out yet, but very tall mountain to climb.
Here's Withers. Cross-checked after getting rid of the ball, but you're absolutely right. I mean, if it wasn't for some of those fantastic saves by Hill, this easily could be, you know, a 10-7 lacrosse game. I know that's a little stating the obvious, but they're right in this one, really. I know Reggie Thorpe will be maybe a little disappointed when it's all said and done, but a strong showing. They're an expansion team.
Hey, you take away that first quarter, and they've been right there.
Bounce pass over, and they have under 6 minutes to work with still. This game isn't over yet. Shot on net, rebound. Hill looking forward, and it bounces over towards the near corner. It'll be a battle for it, and that's one here. Kemble coming in. Emmett Suter, that'd be quite the collision. Fennell with it. Passes it over. Shot coming right on net, it goes in, they score, Keogh. Oh, Bouquet got a piece, just not enough. I'm sure he'd like to have that one back, but it trickles in.
Steven Keogh, who's had four shots already, good scoring opportunities. He's just been snake bitten by Alex Bouquet, and this time he gets a shot to just trickle by the netminder. You'll see it here, barely crossing that line. Bouquet turns around just to see it going over. Steven Keogh. And the Halifax Thunderbirds, they'll take that one. They've got an 11-4 lead.
Just over 5:20 left in this one. First ever game here in Halifax for the National Lacrosse League. And the first game in the history of the New York Riptide. A lot of firsts here tonight. They win the draw. Armstrong comes in. And a chance there, Colton Armstrong. And the ball goes up and out of play. And a souvenir for a student from St. Mary's University coming in, home of the Huskies.
Stephen Kehoe. Assist to number 43, Eric.
Longboat. Longboat here for Kelly.
Watch hold!
And some movement here. Kelly trying to spring loose. Longboat has it. Working one-on-one against Smith. Now play coming out of the far corner. Only 4 seconds left. In the shot clock, right on net. Heel with the save. Rebound. And a full reset. And that's all. Only if New York can hang on to it. But three guys in the corner for Halifax causes a turnover. Here's Smith. Trevor Smith from Brampton, Ontario, and Orangeville, if you will. Bit of a lacrosse factory there, Scott.
It certainly is. Meet lots of lacrosse players coming from that area.
Jameson, nice pass to Benesh. Benesh, a little fake. Backhand shot. And who gave him the save? The fans enjoying the backhanders.
It is the standard backhand we see all the time. We take those plays for granted, and these fans oohing and aahing every time they see it.
Bit of a sidearm shot, and Hill does the splits. Bit of an awkward save there. Oh, it would take me 3 weeks to recover from that one, but Warren Hill got the job done. Keeps it 11-4 here for Halifax, and you are watching the National Lacrosse League on VR Live. It's the play of the game brought to you by Geico. Let's take a look at this one, Scott. What a dandy.
Yeah, Kyle Jackson to start off the second quarter from behind the net, capitalizing on a great loose ball here as Alex Bouquet, the goaltender, makes a gamble. Had it paid off, it would have been a great scoop up. He would have been able to throw it down, but Kyle Jackson, smart play. He scoops it up, goes far side for the dive. And that is our Geico play of the game.
Indeed, Geico, 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance. And that was fun to watch for sure, that one. 11-4 here, later stages of this fourth quarter. Beautiful Halifax, Nova Scotia. It's the Thunderbirds here working the ball. Ryan Benesh off the carpet trying to grab it and go was Keogh. Just couldn't snag it. Riptide. Back the other way, it's Andrew Suter. Suter cradling the ball, waiting for everyone to get into position here. And it's going to be pass in by Digby. And for Connor Kelly, wearing that unique number one, which is not unique to lacrosse. A lot of goalies have worn that over the years, but not too many out players. Shot, but that came after the 32nd shot clock had gone.
We'll see if the Thunderbirds try to slow things down, kill off this 32nd shot clock. Under 3 minutes to go now in this game.
Withers, he will go down in Halifax history as the first ever goal scorer in the Thunderbirds history here in Halifax. 10 seconds into this lacrosse game. Jameson across, nice pass, they score! What a beauty feed. They make it 12-4.
And Stephen Keogh getting his second goal of the game. A bad angle shot. Bouquet tried to slide over. We saw Keogh score from an outside shot just moments ago that trickled in. This time, it barely goes in as well. Bouquet doesn't get a piece of it, but it didn't rocket through like Keogh hoped it would, or maybe he did that on purpose. A little bit of a change up. Either way, it's a 12-4 game for the Thunderbirds.
See the purple shooting string there in the stick of Hossack. Graham Hossack getting a chance to take some draws, and that makes sense. I mean, you know, he's pretty good at the face-offs too. Get him some work in on a real game. Give Withers a bit of a break. on the Halifax side. Fennell will start jogging in a little bit. Passes it over, went off the shaft. He'll battle for it. Burke right in front of his own bench. And now taken again by the Thunderbirds. But they only have 2 seconds left. Seven on the shot clock. Save. And the ball goes up and out of play. And a good scoop by a Lacrosse fan.
These fans love it here. Good ovation. I don't know if that was a one-handed scoop or not, but young fan anyhow catches it right away.
I think it was, because I think the fan had a popcorn or something in the other hand there, so that's what made it an even better grab. 12-4 chance here for New York. Couple fakes and just going wide and paying the price too. A little slow to get up was Thorpe, and the Thunderbird player making sure he was okay. A lot of respect in the league for sure. With under 130 left here in this one. Here's Cody Jamison, the captain here in Halifax, a shot on net, and Bouquet with the save. Andrew Suter gets the ball, passes it up. Shots are 61-41 in favor of Halifax. Digby. Digby gets it over here, longboat over to the far side of the carpet. Couple fakes, a shot, and Warren Hill makes yet another stop. 37 for him tonight so far. With under a minute to go in this one. Kelly, longboat. Moved in a little deeper by Thorpe. Trying to roll. Picardo, big collision there, look out! And getting hit hard is Jake Withers. And that creates a crowd here towards center floor.
Get out, take him.
So Withers bounces up, he's okay.
Yeah.
Digby coming in.
That brought in a big crowd. Withers, his helmet went flying. Still some pushing and shoving out on the floor right now. We've got Luke Magnan, he came to Withers' defense right away. Tyler Digby from the other side. He came in for some help, and it ended up being those two going after it. And the Boo Birds come out here in Halifax as you see Withers takes that hard high hit from Kieran McArdle. The fans now are just seeing that on the big screen as the replay goes up. See how the referees sort this out.
So we're gonna have a 3-minute power play.
Should be 2 minutes for sure, but.
You got it, yeah.
Hearing the referees, they're talking about a 3-minute power play, so I don't know if they're going to give a 5 and a 2.
In home.
At this point
in
of the game.
In home for 5, Magnum for 2.
There we go.
5-2.
Yeah, 5 and 2.
Okay. 5-2. No, 3 minutes is going to go up on the board. 3 minutes is going to go up on the board. Shotty.
Makes things interesting here at the end of this one. The score is
5-on-4.
Out of reach
five on four.
New York to
three
get back into it.
Up. So because we don't have time, if the differential goes up on the board. Just
a little something for the fans to get into late in the game. But yeah, that was a big hit that Withers took. Ricardo.
Well, the fans are looking up on the board and they're showing what you see right now, Luke Magnan in the box. That's what they're booing at. They don't think their man should have got a penalty, but they're still going to have a power play.
Yeah.
5-on-4 when all is said and done as Cody Jamison, the captain of the Thunderbirds, is over there with the referees. Whatever he said just got their minds going.
It's going to be 4-on-4, no? The differential goes up on the board because we don't have time.
We're understanding it, so it's 3-1, but score straight.
No, the 3 minutes goes up because we don't have the time to kill it.
Right.
So it goes 5-on-4.
Okay.
Right? Listen, 32 seconds here.
Some good teamwork there by the officials sorting it out.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. It's a 5 and a 3, which would finish the game. Since there's only 32 seconds left, it would finish it 4-on-4. So what the referees are doing is, well, they're taking that extra 3 minutes and putting it up on the board as a power play for the remaining 30.
Makes sense. Jackson. Benesh. And here come the fans with their applause and appreciation. of their Thunderbirds. I don't think the Thunderbirds are going to try and score here. It's sort of a unwritten rule in lacrosse with such a big lead. You just eat up the clock. And that's what they're going to do here. And that will do it. Halifax defeat New York tonight, 12-4. The inaugural game, first ever win here in Halifax for the Thunderbirds. And they'll head down to congratulate Warren Hill on a good game.
These fans were certainly treated to some good lacrosse in the first pro lacrosse game here in Halifax. It started off with a flurry of goals, seven in that first quarter, including one in the opening 10 seconds. New York found their legs, and then it was back and forth action the rest of the way. Despite the 12-4 score, you take away that 7-0 first quarter. This was one heck of a lacrosse game on both sides.
All right, so let's go down to Dana, who's joined by Warren Hill. Dana?
Yeah, Warren, you really turned it on in the second half. What was said in the locker room?
Not much. All the boys knew what to do, and defense made it really easy for me tonight, so big credit to them.
And the crowd here just erupted after you guys won the game. What was this crowd like here in Halifax?
Oh, it was amazing. It was definitely, they gave us a big boost tonight, and we're all happy to be here.
Awesome. Thanks so much. Go join the high fives. Guys.
All right. Thank you, Dana. Coming up on the NLL postgame live, highlights and analysis of tonight's game. And look at perhaps some scores around the league. All coming up next. You're watching the National Lacrosse League on BR Live. Watching some of the saves. It was mostly saves in the second half of this lacrosse game, Scott.
Yeah, Alex Bouquet with some spectacular saves for the New York Riptide. He kept it a respectable game. I know the score, if you're looking at it, looks like it was a little out of hand, but we keep talking about that first quarter. 7-0, the Thunderbirds led it after the opening quarter. After that, New York turned it around. It was big thanks to the goaltending of Alex Bouquet.
Oh, it certainly was. Some great goaltending in the third and fourth quarters by both goaltenders. We heard from Warren Hill on the postgame show. But overall, just a great start to the National Lacrosse League here in the city of Halifax.
It certainly was. These fans loved it. They stayed right until that final buzzer, despite the score being a little out of hand. I mean, they're used to watching hockey games here, the Halifax Mooseheads, and I'm sure if it's 4-5-0, you start heading to the exit with 3-4 minutes left. All these fans, despite the big gap, they stayed, and they gave a big ovation to this Thunderbirds team. And I don't know if you noticed at the end, but the Thunderbirds, as soon as that buzzer went, they all gathered in center. They put their arms around each other, a big group hug, and then they did a lap around the arena to thank all the fans who came here tonight.
Despite a very slow start, a rough start, I guess you could call it, for New York, Reggie Thorpe, I think, has to be quite happy with a lot of things he did see in the third and fourth quarter moving forward.
Yeah, when he was talking to Dana there during the game, he joked that they're on pace to lose 40-3. Well, they turned things around right after that. So whatever he said to his team at the break, they've got a lot of positives to take out of that. And despite the score being so bad, I keep talking about that first quarter. You take away that 7-0 first quarter, a very respectable game for the Riptide and a very good start to lacrosse here in Halifax.
And certainly no surprises tonight. Some of the big players and some of the keys of the game did, in fact, occur the way you sort of predicted at the start. Cody Jamison was just a calming effect for, I think, some younger players with the Thunderbirds. Not the biggest night offensively for him, but certainly you could just tell that he sort of controlled things at times out there.
Yeah, he controlled the play. He was the quarterback on the power play, and he quarterbacked a lot of the five-on-five as well. So despite him not racking up a lot of points, he got a couple nice assists, but he was in on pretty much everything. He controls that offense. I was very impressed with Austin Shanks and Eric Fennell as well. And, of course, we've talked about the goaltending. I mean, you can't get any better than how Warren Hill was here tonight.
As far as Mike Kersey is concerned, the head coach of the Halifax Thunderbirds, he picks up his first win behind the bench as a head coach.
Big win for Mike Kersey. He's going to be all smiles. He's a pretty happy guy. He loves the game of lacrosse, just like all these guys here, but he's very passionate about it, and he gets rewarded here with a W. His first game as a head coach. We've seen him a lot as a player, a lot as an assistant coach, but to grab the reins of this team and be at the helm and pick up a W here tonight, that's huge. So congratulations to Mike Kersey and the entire Halifax Thunderbirds organization.
Yeah, they've put a lot of work into it here. Obviously, it started kind of unofficially with that canoe paddle that they went in on over the summer and got here, and things are underway here in Halifax on the east coast of Canada.
3 months. Kurt Steyer's the owner, left Six Nations, got in a big canoe. We saw it. It's down here in the arena. It almost looks like a dragon boat, not quite as big, but a very sturdy canoe. You would need that in the rough waters. He went in 3 month voyage from Six Nations with his lacrosse stick to bring the game of lacrosse here to Halifax. It has landed.
Yeah, we want to thank everyone, too, before we wrap up tonight, making this happen as well. Dana doing a great job down there as well. I know she was excited and ready to go and had a busy little bit. So thank you, Dana, as well, as I think we're going to wrap things up here a little bit on NLL post-game. So appreciate you watching. On behalf of Scott Arnold, I'm Pete Dalladay. Good night from Halifax.